Venga, lookin' at here, baby.
Fuck. Lookin' at here, lookin' at here.
We're gonna have to fight good. That was the headbutt. Was the headbutt?
Yeah, we got it.
It's good. It's good. Don't worry about it.
Is that good stuff, right?
It's headbutt or the scorecard. Don't worry about it. Okay. Put it on. Put it on. Pick them up, baby. You can do this. Okay. You fight before with broken arm.
Yeah, fine. Don't worry about it. Fine. See, fine.
She's ahead in this fight, so in a way, for her, if this fight will stop, it might end up being better for her than if she moves forward.
It continues to have to open that up.
Well, exactly.
Keep her action for a few months.
Precisely. And so, that's an issue.
The only thing, you know, we say that as commentators say a lot of times. My fight is not the nature of a fighter. You know,
no, there isn't.
They
want to compete. Yeah.
Right hand, good digging body shot in the south of the border. Now, if another McCarty was frustrated before, McCarty's a little frustrated now. She didn't like the idea that she's been cut. Round 7, McCarty trying to hold her off, and Larry Puente coming on. Nice uppercut on the inside by McCarty. Larry Puente forcing this round. I gave Larry Puente the last round, by the way.
It's coach out of hand either, so you're actually in agreement with that. You're getting closer to the
It's better for our viewers to see the way the judges could be seeing it. We don't agree with every round. And, you know, good judges that watch fights, and I learned this from going to the various conventions of the sanctioning bodies, that 40% of professional judges disagree on the close 10-9 round.
And I'll tell you what, Laura Prenta is finding a hold for that hook, and she's using the right hand. I just turned into an excellent round of boxing. This fight, she could lose it still with the decision. Unless she knocks her out.
See, the difference, folks, if that was caused by a punch, that's why the headbutt is so important. If it was caused by a punch and the fight stopped, the person is cut, and they can't continue to lose the fight. But on an accidental headbutt, the person that's cut, it doesn't make any difference. It just shows the scorecard, so you got to be ahead. That's why Al was saying that we're sure that that was a headbutt, and as he said that, sure enough, the mission across the 100 decides that it was a headbutt.
Great body shot a moment ago by McCarty, that slowed Larry Puente down to the block to rock. Now remember, we're in the 7th round. We're at the end of the round, we'll be past the point that these women have ever fought, because we'll be at the 21-minute mark.
And it hasn't slowed down much at all, has it? Especially, we're in the last, coming up to 30 seconds of the 3rd minute of the 7th round, and the pace is still fast and furious.
Very good round for Belinda Larapenta.
Larry Dips comes with the uppercut, then the light hook, but no damage done at all. Larapenta looks a little gassed right now in the last few seconds here of the 7th round, but she really let it fly in this round. McCarty trying to finish strong in this round. Luis Tapia, veteran cornerman, knows exactly how to close those up. And it's a bad cut, mind you, but as Al and I mentioned, below the eye. This is round number 8. It's scheduled for 10. This is no man's land for no women that have ever been here before.
Interesting, it's going to start moving. No women's professional boxers ever fought this actual amount of boxing in
a 22nd minute of boxing. So here we go.
We're coming in with that elbow, Belinda.
Round number 8. CSI Sports. We're at the Orleans in Las Vegas, Nevada. Al Bernstein and Ed the Colonel join bringing you this fight, because this is a very good professional fight. Forget about the fact that women, this is a good pro fight. Two very well-conditioned athletes fighting a real battle. I get only 1 point separating them now, as Belinda Larapenta has come on in the last couple of rounds. And I gave you one of the early rounds.
Yeah, she had a very good round in the last round. McCarty's off to a
arm hits her on top of the head. There's an example, as you said about three rounds ago, where she fought Paul, and when Makata took that dip, she just took advantage of it, hitting around the temporal area in the front bones on her nose that time. So maybe she heard this, or maybe somebody in that corner.
That would be the first boxer ever to actually listen to this.
Good one. And Makata needed this round because I thought Larry Quinn had been coming up.